Hallelujah, church. How many of you are glad to be back in the presence of God this week? Amen. Hallelujah. You know, Pastor released a blessing last Sunday. Hallelujah. He released us, hallelujah, into the blessing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah of God's DNA. Amen. Hallelujah. We all have God's children have His DNA. Amen. Amen. That means we're no longer bound by our mistakes. Hallelujah. We're no longer bound by our past curses. Hallelujah. We're called to live in our Father's inheritance. Amen. Amen. How many of you believe that and are confident in that? Hallelujah. So won't you worship the Lord with me? Hallelujah. You're back in your Father's house. Hallelujah. Amen. And we're going to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. For the inheritance that He has kept for us. Amen. Amen. Oh, won't you put your hands together, church?
Joy unspeakable, faith unsinkable, love unstoppable, anything is possible. Joy unspeakable, faith unsinkable, love unstoppable, anything
just prophesy this over your life.
Joy unspeakable, faith unsinkable, love unstoppable, anything is possible. Joy unspeakable, faith unsinkable, love unstoppable. Faith unsinkable, love unstoppable. unshakable, faith unsinkable, love unstoppable, anything is possible, joy unspeakable, faith unsinkable, love unstoppable, anything is possible, joy unspeakable, faith unsinkable, love unstoppable.
Yeah. pastor declared a word on Sunday, and I'll just read it out to you. Hallelujah. Consider now from this day forward, from the 24th day of the 9th month, from the day that the foundations of the Lord temple was laid, consider it. Is the seed still in the barren? As yet the vine, the fig tree, the pomegranate, and the olive tree have not yet yielded fruit, but from this day I will bless you.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. There's a from now, hallelujah, blessing in this day, O Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. There's a from now on blessing in our midst. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. From now on, hallelujah, we're not going to be bound by our past, O Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. We're not going to be bound by our mistakes. Hallelujah. From now on, we're going to be walking in the favor of God. Amen. Amen. How many of you believe that God has a new thing? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Kept in store for you. Hallelujah. From now on. Amen. You're going to be walking in favor. Hallelujah. You're going to be walking in inheritance. Hallelujah. Amen. You're going to be walking, amen, just as if nothing has ever happened. Hallelujah. Just amen. As if you had never sinned. Amen. Amen. God's grace is here. Hallelujah. To justify you. Amen. To make you just as if you had never sinned. Hallelujah. So there's a new thing. Hallelujah. In this place today. Hallelujah. Amen. And I dare you to receive it. To expect from the Lord. Amen. Because He's going to work it in your life. Amen. Hallelujah.
Right here, right now, there is a fresh wind, and I can hear the sound. Something truly wonderful is happening. There is a difference inside of me, more than a feeling. This is a prophecy. Something really right here and now, there is a fresh wind, and I can hear the sound. Something truly wonderful is happening. There is a difference inside of me. It's more than a feeling. This is a prophecy. Something really an anointing
got a new thing coming. I got a new thing coming.
I got a new mind, new heart, fresh faith. Oh, I got a new wine, now what?
I got a new thing coming. I got a new mind, new heart, fresh faith.
I got a new
problems, hallelujah, every situation that you are in, hallelujah, and just declare this by faith, hallelujah, amen, hallelujah. God is going to do a new thing. He's going to bring you out of every pit, amen. He's going to reverse every curse, amen. So I want you to declare this by faith, hallelujah.
Oh, darkness battle to the day.
Thank you. Come expecting, hallelujah, church. You know, hallelujah, just like the woman with the issue of blood. blood. Hallelujah. She went to the presence of Jesus expecting her healing. Hallelujah. She expected when she touched the hem of the garment that she would be healed. Hallelujah. Are you expecting this day? Hallelujah. Amen. What promises are you holding on to? Hallelujah. This day. Amen. Today is your Kairos moment. Hallelujah. The Lord is here to fulfill the promises over your life. Hallelujah. The promises that have been declared. Hallelujah. If only you would receive it. If only you would expect it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I encourage you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Take hold of your Kairos moment. Hallelujah. Bless the Lord with me. Hallelujah. As we take hold of our promises. Hallelujah.
Then
So just look unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, just worship Him. Hallelujah. He's here to bless you this day. Hallelujah. Just shout unto your Father. Hallelujah. He's here. Hallelujah. He's looking unto His child. Hallelujah. With love. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And He's here to bless you this day. Oh, just look unto Him. Just cry out to Him. Hallelujah. Your Father's here. Hallelujah. To help you. Hallelujah. We worship you, Jesus.
Thank you.
यीशु तेरा नाम रहे ऊंचा।
Some presence in this house upon all those who are watching in their homes, Lord. We thank you, Lord, hallelujah, for loving us, Lord, constantly, hallelujah, Lord, without, hallelujah, Lord Jesus, Lord, charging our sin against us, but hallelujah, forgiving us and cleansing us and looking unto us with love and favor and honor, Lord. Oh, we want to cling to you tonight. Oh, I'm not a because he clings to me, he'll deliver us, Lord. Avan njangale viduvippikkum ennu karthaal. Oh, Rabban kadaga manasam bhooriyadara kadaga adara kadaga manasya. As we're coming to the end of the month, we want to thank you for all that you have done in this month, oh Lord. Innumerable mercy, innumerable times that you, hallelujah, lifted us, Lord. Oh, we give you glory, Lord. Ralbariya sambhooriyadara adara. Oh, radara adara. Somebody with neck pain, God is healing you right now. In the name of Jesus, I release and loose you by the power of the Holy Spirit. Somebody, you are connected with your hallelujah mole, a mole on your face. I don't know what about it. The Lord is touching you. Hallelujah. Samboria. Somebody is looking very discouraged sitting in your couch. God is saying, be encouraged today. Samboria. Fear not, for I'm with you, said the Lord. Fear not, Abraham, I am your shield and your great reward. Samboria. We thank you for the healing anointing, restoring grace that is moving through the camera into the hearts of the people. We thank you, Lord. We pray that you touch hearts tonight. Hallelujah, Lord. We promise you, Lord, to give you all the glory and the honor. In Jesus' mighty and precious name, Father, we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. What a joy once again to come. Last week of September, the year passed us so fast. But God is good. And his faithfulness endureth forever. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Tonight we want to continue with the series on faith. Pastor has been teaching us on faith. Let's open our Bibles to Hebrews chapter 12, verses 1 and 2. Hallelujah. How many of your Bible tonight? Hallelujah. Hebrews chapter 12. Hallelujah. One of my favorite scriptures. Hallelujah. Glory to God. If you have a Bible, take it, read it, put your name there. Hallelujah. It says, therefore we also, since we are surrounded by a so great cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and he has sat at the right hand of the throne of God. Powerful word. Hallelujah. Wherefore, seeing we also compassed with so great cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which easily beset us. Let us run with patience the race that is set before us. KJV version. Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising his shame, sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Hallelujah. This evening our focus is on the Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says he's the rose of Sharon. He's the fairest of 10,000. He's the lily of the valley. He's the Alpha. He's the Omega. He's the beginning. He's the end. He's the prophet who Moses prophesied, like just like me, will come. Hallelujah. Glory to God. He's the savior of our lives. He's the one who will beautify us with salvation. Hallelujah. Let's look to the face of Jesus. He's the face that was marked for you and me, that our life and our countenance will look, hallelujah, pretty. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. There is no spot or blemish in him. His name is Jesus, the Son of the living God. Let us lift up that name. Bible says, let us as a church look unto this Jesus, the author and the perfecter of our faith. Oh, hallelujah. How many of you love this Jesus this morning? Hallelujah. How many of you love this Jesus? Lift your hands and thank the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. When you study Hebrews 11, Hebrews 12, speaking about great men and women of faith, As a matter of fact, Hebrews 12 starts with, let us therefore surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, the grandstand. Hallelujah. Witnesses of faith who has gone before us. Hallelujah. Looking at the church. Hallelujah. There's a grandstand of people seeing what we are doing. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. How we are responding to the words of life. Glory to God. Amen. How we are running the race. Enduring the cross. How we are going through the test. How we are going through the storms. Hallelujah. There is a grandstand of great crowd of witnesses. Men and women of faith looking at us. Can you imagine Noah, Abel, Enoch, Moses, Joshua, Rahab, Ruth. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, the heroes of faith. Samson, Jephthah, Isaiah, Jeremiah, the prophets. All looking at us. How we are running this race. Looking to the face of Jesus. Come on, somebody. What a privilege to be a part. Oh, hallelujah. Sharing this legacy and heroes of faith. Hallelujah. Living and walking the life of faith. Oh, glory to God. Amen. But the Bible says, though all of them are around us, we don't look at them, but we look to Jesus. ഇവരെല്ലാം ചുറ്റിരുമുണ്ടെങ്കിലും നമ്മുടെ കാഴ്ച, നമ്മുടെ കണ്ണ് നട്ടിരിക്കുന്നത് യേശുവിലേക്ക് മാത്രം. Our eyes are fixed on Jesus himself, the author and the finisher of our faith, because he is our pattern, he is our example. He is the forerunner who has run before us and showed us how to, hallelujah, run this race with endurance. There are seven things pastor said that are mentioned here that we want to highlight. It says, let us lay aside every weight. Let us lay aside every weight and the sin. Weight, sin. Let us run with patience. Patience, looking unto Jesus. He endured the cross, despising the shame. Sat at the right hand of God the Father. Sat at the throne of God, the right hand of God. Seven things. Wait, sin, patience, looking unto Jesus. Endured, despising the shame. Throne of God. Pastor said, we don't need to have giant kind of faith. If you have the faith of a mustard seed, you can command the mountain to uproot itself. Hallelujah. Or the mulberry tree to uproot itself and be cast into the sea. It shall happen. If you have a faith of a mustard seed, if you have a small, tiny faith, you can command the mountain, the sycamore tree, to be cast out. It will be cast out. This is the faith. Hallelujah. We have to put it to work. Hallelujah. The tiny, hallelujah, the faith. Hallelujah. Great potential. It is not about the magnitude of your faith. It is where it is the faith that you are willing to put it to work. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Even small seed of faith has to put it to work. Amen. Hallelujah. As tiny as a mustard seed can work miracles. ഇന്ന് നിന്റെ വിശ്വാസം ചെറുതാണെങ്കിലും അതിൻ്റെ അകത്ത് അത്ഭുതങ്ങൾ നടക്കുന്ന, ഹല്ലേലൂയ, ദൈവത്തിൻ്റെ അത്ഭുത ശക്തി ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ അതിനായിട്ട് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്താട്ടെ. Though your faith is as tiny as the mustard seed, there are mountain moving. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Miracle working power in the inside of it. Oh, put it to work this morning. Call upon the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. You are going to move mountain. We are going to move mountain. Come on. This morning in the name of the Lord. Glory to God. Amen. But pastor said, you have to move a mountain. For you to move mountains, you have to have a giant character. Hallelujah. Giant-like character. Not a giant of faith, but giant-like character to exercise the authority. We know without faith it is impossible to please God. We know faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. We know faith is a connector rod that brings what is in the invisible to the visible. We know faith connects us to the supernatural. We know faith is believing first, then seeing. We know that for faith, you need to seek Him first. He who comes to me must believe that I exist, that I'm a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. So seeking comes first, then faith follows. And here it says, for our faith to work, we need to have character. For in Hebrews 11, none of them is said that by faith they got a healing. None of them is mentioned as by faith they built great business and great houses. Nowhere in Hebrews 11 says by faith they bought a Mercedes Benz. Not single one of Hebrews 11 is not mentioned as by faith they bought this land or estate. Because many people think God has to bless you with three houses or four vehicles for you to prove yourself as a man of God or a woman of God. That's not the case. When we, you know, that's not what we teach. Because look at the word achievement. What we achieve in life, we think faith is about personal achievement. Vishwasam ennu parayunnathu, it's not personal achievement. Hallelujah. Faith is an assignment. Today, if you want to title the word faith for assignment, faith is not an achievement. Hallelujah. What we achieve in life, we think that it's all about personal achievement. No. We rarely attach assignment to faith. It's about what is the assignment of my life, and I'm supposed to do it by faith through grace. Look at Paul. He said, I am what I am by the grace of God. For I've labored more than anybody else, but not me, but by the grace of God. He was assignment conscious. You look at people in the Bible, they were assignment conscious. Paul, a servant of God, called to be an apostle. He was assignment conscious. All the disciples left the boat because the Bible says, I'll make you fishers of men. They were assignment conscious. Jesus, when he said, not my will, let your will be done, he was assignment conscious. He said, my food is not to, hallelujah, anything else, but to, my food is to finish my work that God has assigned for me. He was assignment conscious to finish the work. What are you conscious about? Hebrews 11, speaking about great cloud of witnesses, are people who fulfill their God-given assignments, not achievements. Tonight, we need to have a shift. Hallelujah. In our understanding, we need to shift into God's purposes and plans into a higher level, not just achievement, achieving something, but the assignment God, and say, Lord, I want to step into the fulfilling the plan and the purposes of God. Devathinte chila pravarthanangale enikku vendi munkooti angu karthave kandu, hallelujah, adilekku chikeruvan enikku kripa tharana karthave, help me to, for beforehand, in the Bible the words are used, that is used beforehand. Hallelujah. Nee janikkunnathinu munpa, nee amme udarathil aagunnathinu munpa, deva yesu christuvil ninakku, hallelujah, chila pravarthiyum planum paddhathi orukki adinte beforehand what God has prepared, even before you were thought and knitted in the mother's womb. Oh, there is a beforehand plan and purpose. God wants you to step into that plan. How many of you believe? Lift your hands and say, Lord, help me, Lord. Hallelujah. We have only one life. I forgot who said, he said, we have only time to fulfill God's plan. I think Pastor himself said, we have only time to fulfill the plan of God, nothing else. All Roberts, it was said about all Roberts, he was compelled by the Spirit. He felt that he was had an assignment from God. And that's what all that you're supposed to do. Pastor said when he was in Los Angeles of Amy Simple MacPherson's Four Square Church, one of her faith statement was written there. She felt God has assigned her to raise up Four Square Church. The word that was used was God told her son will never sit on the Four Square Church. Oh, hallelujah. That's why the church is over 100 nations. Hallelujah. She said she felt she was assigned to do something like that. You'll feel compelled to do what you're assigned. What is the use of building three or four buildings and making five businesses and buying 10 cars? One day you will die. It may be 50 years from now, 60 years from now, 70 years. Everything that we have has to be connected to the assignments. You know, people should not look and say, hey, he had 7 cars, he had 5 houses. But 100 years from now, people should say, look what God has used him for. Look what the Lord has done through him. Look at what, hallelujah, a blessing that has become to the body of Christ. That's what people should say about you. He finished his course. Hallelujah. There is an assignment over every child of God. Abraham was not trying to get a baby by faith. He went out of the Ur of Chaldeans to the place that God has shown him. That's what he used the faith for. He stepped out. He left everything to fulfill the assignment of God. And the Bible says the God of glory appeared before Mesopotamia and said, leave your father's house, leave your kindred, leave your people, leave your country and go into the land that I will show you. He stepped out because of the assignment God has placed within him. Tonight, that the Holy Spirit sharpen your senses to hear the voice of God. May you have divine encounters of the glory of God in your life. ഇരുട്ടിന്റെ പോരുകൾ വിട്ടുപോട്ടെ യേശുവിന്റെ നാമത്തിൽ. Oh, hallelujah. Look at Noah. By faith, he built an ark for the saving of his family. He had an assignment. He built an ark. He didn't say, I built an ark. He didn't say, I'm pretty good with this. I know to build an ark and, you know, I'm better than anybody else. No. He didn't say, you know, maybe I'm so good that I should build a home also. He didn't say I have a great talent. Maybe I'm made for this. Maybe I should build myself a textile industry. No, he was looking, all of them were conscious about their assignment. He accomplished by faith that the assignment that God has put him on earth for. What has God put you on earth for? Ninne bhoomiyil irikkunna endinu vendiyana. There is an assignment that comes from God. Some of you are looking only by faith to see your personal achievement. Adinu vendi aagarudhu. When John the Baptist said, let you increase and I decrease, adu endina paranjathu? Lord, so that I will fulfill your assignment. എല്ലാവരും എന്നെ ബാപ്റ്റിസ്റ്റ് ഹല്ലേലൂയ എന്ന് വിളിക്കാനല്ല. ദൈവം പറഞ്ഞു, നിന്നെ മുൻപാകെ പോകുന്നവൻ, വൺ ഗോസ് ബിഫോർ മീ, ഹല്ലേലൂയ, അവൻ ഞാനാണ്, അത് ചെയ്യുവാനുള്ള കൃപ എനിക്ക് തരണം. ഹല്ലേലൂയ, ദാറ്റ് ഐ ഷൽ ഗോ ബിഫോർ യു ആൻഡ് മേക്ക് ദി ക്രൂക്കഡ് വേ സ്ട്രൈറ്റ്. ഹല്ലേലൂയ, ഐ ആം കോൾഡ് ആൻഡ് അസൈൻഡ് ഫോർ ദാറ്റ്. അതർവൈസ് if you go after the personal achievement, you will miss out on God big time. Faith is important to fulfill God's assignment in your life. When God, you know, told Pastor years back about Joshua Generation Ministries, he did not start it because he stepped out by faith as a young man to start something. That's what people thought. this boy has gone crack. That's not the reason. God told him, hallelujah, to start it, to reach to the 104 nations of the world with the gospel of Jesus Christ, to have a vision for four generations. He heard the Lord and he stepped out by faith and he paid the cost, not for personal achievement, but to fulfill the plan and the purpose of God. You can only deny yourself and take up the cross and think about paying the cost and all that when you have an assignment consciousness. That's where you exercise the faith, hallelujah, big time. Some people have only faith to see their breakthrough, their miracle, their healing. God will do that. But that pastor said these are add-ons. It's like he said, when you buy dosa, sambar and chutney comes free. Everything else is add-on. In the same way, when you are on the assignment of God, there are things God will add on to your life. Oh, hallelujah. It might be a good car, a good house, even maybe a good holiday. It is all add-ons. If you are Aaron, your assignment is to stand up with Moses. Aaron was only supposed to say what Moses says, what God spoke to Moses. Moses will say to Aaron and Aaron will say it. Some people have a problem with, why are you preaching pastor's message? This is because that's what Aaron was assigned to do. Aaron was not assigned to speak anything what he wanted, but what God spoke to Moses. Moses himself was a talented man, a pyramid, born in Pharaoh's court, an intelligent man, but God broke him so much in the wilderness that Moses did not utter anything what he wanted, but what he heard from the mountain. Aaron was supposed to speak what Moses heard from the mountain. Joshua was supposed to speak what Moses told him to speak. Oh, hallelujah. It is the God-given responsibility. The difference between you and somebody else is their assignment. I might not like be another preacher's because they are assigned to be another preacher. I'm not assigned to be that. I'm assigned to be what God has called me to do. The difference between you and your neighbor, your assignment that God has specified for you. It is not in your money, not in your talent, car, bicycle. The difference is in your assignment, the God-given responsibility. Devan thanna chumathalayilana vithyasam. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you know your assignment? If you ask the Holy Spirit, sometimes it might to fulfill the assignment of a church that you're planted in. Be a part and parcel of that. Don't try to, hallelujah, have your own set of people, own groups, own clubs inside the church. Don't try to be a leader of four few people. Assignment is to see the plan and the purposes of God fulfilled. Otherwise, you'll become a control freak. Everybody wants to control their space. God can never use control freaks. Because God says, I am the sovereign God. I am the one who is on the throne. The moment Lucifer tried to control what God is supposed to control, he was thrown out. So that's not a space to do what God has called us to do. And you'll be rewarded for that. To fulfill God-given assignment, that's what we are into today. You need a strong character. That's how faith operates. Seven character traits in Hebrews 12. When you're walking by faith, your character changes. Faith unto faith. In the righteousness, reveal faith unto faith. It changes people. Faith in Him. Faith in His Word. Faith in the finished work of Jesus Christ. Faith in the blood of Jesus. Faith in the mercy of God. Faith in the grace of God. It changes you. Faith itself is a character. Because your faith will talk for you without you talking. Nee samsaarikkaa ninde vishwasam ninakkayittu samsaarikkum. without you posting on Instagram or Facebook, your faith will talk for you without you talking. Some of us are so busy looking what you have and putting in the Facebook and YouTube comments that are all part of your assignments, not to see how many views that you have got. Don't even look at the views. Don't even look at the comments. Whatever the Lord has said, let the Lord do. Let the Holy Spirit wind. Take the message to the people who God has assigned this message for. That's my always my prayer. Lord, even if 1,000 people are not assigned to hear this message where I'm speaking, let that one person who is assigned to hear this message, let him not miss it. First character the Bible says is, out of seven things, lay aside every weight. Do not worry, the Bible says. Sometimes people don't take it literally. Do not worry. Be anxious for nothing. Lay aside every weight. It's a command. Not whether you feel it or not. You have to lay aside. Means unnecessarily don't allow distraction or hindrances to come. Paul faced many hindrances, but he laid aside. He had the ability to focus on the assignment God has called him. That's why he said, I fought the good fight. I finished the race. I was not distracted. I finished the race that was kept for me. I finished the course. I've kept the faith. Many hindrances, many distractions will come. Hallelujah. Weight. Sometimes you know we take go to the gym, take weight. That's not the weight I'm talking about. It means unnecessary baggage. Hallelujah. Avisham illatha chumada. Nee chumannondu nadana ninne kartav eppichathile ninakku cheyan pattathilla. Hallelujah. Just imagine somebody 100 meter race in the Olympics, and just imagine he's holding a huge bag on his back, trying to run, taking 5 dumbbells. Hallelujah. Trying to run the 100 feet race. Won't happen. So they make sure that every weight is thrown away. Even the hairs in their body, they shave it so that nothing will hinder them from reaching their finishing lines. Some of us have too much of baggage. That's why we're getting tired, frustrated. Sometimes being on the social media, watching too much of movies. Hallelujah. Speaking about too many people. It's a baggage that will stop us from reaching where we have a judgment for everybody. We have an opinion about everybody. We have an opinion about everything. But Psalmist did not say that. Psalmist says, I do not speak things are too wonderful for me, or things that are too. No, there are things beyond me. I don't waste things speaking about it. Hallelujah. Those are not the things that you should be looking at. We don't want a weight. Sometimes your company has to, you know, be so small that you don't have to unnecessary weight. You have to put a filter on your mouth and see, is this what I'm speaking? Is this in line with my assignment? Is what God has called me to do? Even ministerial opportunities. Don't go looking after for ministry. Is it what God has called me to do? Is it with my assignment? Is it with flowing with what God has called me to do? ദൈവം വിളിച്ചത് നിൽക്കണം. വേറെ ഏത് ശുശ്രൂഷ ആയിക്കോട്ടെ, ദൈവം വിളിക്കാത്തതാണെങ്കിൽ പോകരുത്, ചെയ്യരുത്. താങ്ക് യു ജീസസ്. സേ താങ്ക് യു ജീസസ്. താങ്ക് യു ജീസസ്. ചില ബന്ധനങ്ങൾ ഇന്ന് അഴിയുന്നു. ഹല്ലേലൂയ. സം സ്ട്രോങ് ഹോൾഡ്സ് ആർ ഗെറ്റിംഗ് ബ്രോക്കൺ ടുഡേ. ഓ ഹല്ലേലൂയ. ഗോഡ്സ് ഗ്രേസ് ആൻഡ് ബ്ലെസ്സിംഗ് ഈസ് ഫ്ലോയിങ് അപ്പോൺ യു. താങ്ക് യു ജീസസ്. Glory to God. Thank you. Second character, sin. Lay aside every weight and the sin. Sin is equal to offense. Whatever causes offense into your life, by faith, you have to uproot it. This may make you stumble. Binnadeyada voices, offended voices. You're getting hurt with people. It will make you, cause you to stumble. Just imagine trying to run a race. Somebody keeps tripping you. That's what sin is. You keep tripping you. Offenses keep tripping you. You're falling down, getting up, falling down. How will you do your assignment? Otherwise, you know, some people say, let us eat and drink, and one day you will die and I will die. Tomorrow we'll all die. No purpose in life. You have to have a purpose in life. God has called you, saved you by His blood, justified by His blood. Hallelujah. Angels witnessed it. Glory to God. He has chosen you. Set your life apart to bear fruit that will last. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. He has put you and planted in your church. It is not for you to go back and to sin and continue with it. But you have to go to fulfill your responsibility. You go after the vision and the responsibility God has put over your life. Then you will not keep walking and keep tripping and keep stumbling and keep getting offended and keep doing the wrong stuff. Now, number three, the Bible says the third character that we need to have is patience. Equals to consistency, constant consistency, continuous consistency. If you abide in my word, in John 8:31 says, if you abide in my word, you are truly my disciples. Abide, stay close every day, read, meditate, walk, talk. What? Abide in your word. You shall continue with me and you shall know the truth and the truth shall set you free. That is what a disciple is like. That is what discipleship is like. In John 15:9, it says, if you continue in my love, hallelujah, you have to continue in a relationship with God. There's a continuation. Everybody say continuation. In a race, you know what I'm saying? Hallelujah. What do we mean by patience? The way you understand patience is not a good thing. Because we are looking for, you know, sometimes speed. Somebody at the starting line, 100 meters is very patient. When pistol is fired, he's very patient. He's chewing the gum and starting. That's not what I'm speaking about, being patient. We're looking for speed. In the Bible, in the realm of the spirit, pastor said speed is equal to consistency. What you are doing every day on a longer period of time. രാവിലെ എഴുന്നേറ്റു, പ്രാർത്ഥിച്ചു, ബൈബിള് വായിച്ചു, ആരാധിച്ചു, സ്തുതിച്ചു, യേശുവിന്റെ രക്തത്താൽ വിളിച്ചു, വചനം സംസാരിച്ചു, വചനം കേട്ടു. Get up in the morning, pray, read the word, speak the word, lift your hands, praise the Lord. A consistency. It's not like first meter, 10 meter, you're accelerated, just out, go up. You know, it's like how I went for cross country. First 10 meters, overtook everybody, but came very last. Thodangal bayangir gembira. Avasana thalanda madudu. Ayyo. Angane illa, not like that. Consistency. Not like that, you know, after some time you're crawling and then you're getting up. If you're always like that, 10 meter speed, then, oh, pastor, I'm with you. Oh, the church go to the next level. After some time, crawling. It's a spirit. When God cursed the snake, The Bible says snake was crawling. Till that night, snake was not crawling. She was walking. He was the most beautiful creature. The curse came upon the snake. The serpent started crawling. And that's when the snake attack you. When the snake poison penetrates you, you will start crawling in your Christian walk. May that curse be broken over your life. Lift your hands and say, I will not crawl anymore. യേശുവിന്റെ നാമത്തിൽ ആ പാമ്പിന്റെ, ഓ വിഷപ്പാമ്പിന്റെ, സർപ്പത്തിന്റെ ഓ കെണിയിൽ നിന്ന് നിന്നെ വിടുവിപ്പിക്കുവാൻ, come out of the snare and the curse of the serpent, take authority over it. I rebuke it in the name of the Lord. Loose. ഭാര്യാദ രാജരമന സംഭോരിയാദ രമനസ്. Crawled on the dust of the earth. Dust is a flesh, very fleshy. Hallelujah. So anything that makes you crawl is not from God. How are you? Somehow managing. I rebuke it. It's crawling. That's not what God has called you to do. Hallelujah. You have to have a divine consistency, grace to be consistent, focus on Jesus. Pastor said inconsistent people will never finish their assignment. Hallelujah. One thing, look at Paul, one thing I do, forget what lies behind, looking ahead. Hallelujah. Oh, adhuvalaya porayilulladhu njan marakkunu, munnilulladhu njan nokkunu, porayilulladhu njan marakkunu, munnilulladhu njan nokkunu. All Roberts was asked, what was the secret of your life? Why are you looking so young? Nee endha cherppakaranayittu irikku? Njanu കഴിഞ്ഞ മിനിറ്റ് സംഭവിച്ച് ഞാൻ ചിന്തിക്കത്തില്ല. പുറകിലുള്ളതിനെ മറക്കുന്നു, മുന്നിലുള്ളതിനെ നോക്കുന്നു. എല്ലാവരും പറഞ്ഞു, ഫോർഗെറ്റിംഗ് വാട്ട് ലൈസ് ബിഹൈൻഡ്, ലുക്കിംഗ് എഹെഡ്. ഹല്ലേലൂയാ. മുന്നിലുള്ളതിനെ നോക്കുന്നു. ഇന്ന് രാത്രികാലവും നീ മുന്നിലുള്ളതിനെ നോക്കട്ടെ. ടുനൈറ്റ് മേ യു ലുക്ക് തിങ്സ് ദാറ്റ് ആർ എഹെഡ് ഓഫ് യു, നോട്ട് വാട്ട് ഈസ് ലൈക്ക് ബിഹൈൻഡ്. ഗ്ലോറി ടു ഗോഡ്. മേ ഐസ് ബി ഓപ്പൺ. ഓ ലെറ്റ് ദേർ ബി എ എനർജി ടു ലുക്ക് എഹെഡ്. ഓ കാകാ ഉറാദാ ബാഷദരാ. വിക്ടറി ബൈ ദി ബ്ലഡ് ഓഫ് ജീസസ്. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Pastor said to get up in the morning, he kneel, he pray in tongues, he read the word, he had a word to carry on, you know, through the entire day. That word will be fire for years, 20 years, 30 years. This is what you are doing, and see what man of God has raised him into levels of glory. When you get the money, first go the tithe, consistent, then the offering, consistent, then eventually you will see your finances will go into next level, because God, hallelujah, will prosper you. It's not an emotional moment when you are running, you know, it's not emotional. Some people is emotional people stops in between when the emotions go down. They will move from one revival meeting to another revival meeting. അങ്ങനെയല്ല. And then later on you come to church crawling. Crawling or jumping like a frog? I'm saying രണ്ട്. Praise God. തവളയുടെ സ്വഭാവം കാണിക്കല്ലേ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു. You have to look at somebody. Don't show the character of a frog. Hallelujah. Consistency is not boring. You know, some of us are not consistent with our breakfast. My dad used to be consistent, two bullseye every day for years. I say, for us, morning sometimes parotta, sometimes kappa biryani. So consistent. Pastor said he's consistent. He eats fruits, juice, then breakfast. Same thing, same pattern. Consistent in your prayer life, in your worship, coming to church, whatever happens, not negotiable. Whenever I am asked to come for the ministry, Lord, give me the grace to be there on time. Not when I'm convenient for me. You cannot lose 20 kgs in gym in one day. No matter if you run 24 hours in a treadmill, you won't. It's not intensity. It's consistency. Whether you are in trouble, whether you are sick, challenged, consistent in your prayer life. I'm releasing a grace like that. Hallelujah. Oh, Ral Bharigada. Other day when I was in prayer in the last week or so, I felt a greater consistency coming upon my own life. I'm releasing that over your life in the name of Jesus. Receive it by faith. In marriage, be consistent. First year of marriage, you're on fire for your spouse. Second year onwards, no love. Don't like to be there together. You don't like to talk to each other. You don't like to see their face. Pastor, church is very funny. What do you want to do? Praise. Give me some. Praise the Lord. Somehow trying to escape home. So, Pastor, put me in this ministry, that ministry. Hallelujah. Third thing is consistency. Number fourth is looking unto Jesus. That is focus. Look at Rahul Dravid. So focused in his defense. Very difficult to get him out. Because he's focused like an eagle. Eagle sees a fish from the mountaintop in the sea and will fly, come towards it. Long range vision. Another fish might be jumping. Imagine that. His face, his eyes is on bald spot. And the other one is, Karupa is there. But his eyes is, he will not get distracted. He will go for that bald spot. Take it and fly up. Hallelujah. Some people say, I was planning to go to this church. I thought this was my church. But there are too many hours, you know, jumping and praising and too many hours. So, you know, you look at your focus is gone. Pearl spot is gone. Now Karupa is, church Karupa is next to my house. 1 hour of worship, 1 hour of praise, no English Malayalam translation, no wastage of time. Won't take time to meet the pastor. Whatever I tell, pastor will do it. You want that kind of a pastor, then you go to Karupa. But if you want to see your life assignment fulfilled, come to the place where God has planted you in. Ralbharia, Kadagadara, Juradara, Barastaria. Victory by the blood of Jesus. Glory to God. Oh, every knee will bow. Oh, every tongue confess. Oh, every knee will bow. Oh, every tongue confess. Oh, every knee will bow. Oh, every tongue confess. Oh, yeah. Oh, every knee will bow. Oh, every tongue confess. Oh, every knee will bow. Oh, rather, oh, every tongue. Every knee will bow. Oh, every knee will bow. Oh, that Jesus, Jesus Christ is Lord. To glorify His name. Oh, every knee will bow. Oh, every knee will bow. Oh, every time. Every knee will bow. Oh, every tongue confess. Jesus Christ is Lord. To glorify His name. To glorify His name. Amen. Hallelujah. Looking unto Jesus. If at all I bow, I not bow before man, I bow before Jesus. Not the pressures of people, but the pressures of man. Galatians 1:10 is that if I'm still trying to become the servant of man, I cannot be a servant of God. Glory to God. Now, Pastor was speaking. In the prophetic world, people will say, I got a confirmation. It's not a confirmation. It is your disobedience that God has to tell you again. Look at Abraham, Enoch, Noah. They built an ark for 120 years, so focused. No sigh of rain. God didn't speak to Noah every morning and said, do this, do that. God spoke to him once and faithful with 100 years with that. Some people say, God spoke to me again and again. It's because you are disobedient. You're thief. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God is telling you the same thing again, again, again. It's not positive, it's negative. Whether it's in your business, focus is what God needs for you to do what God has called you to do. Do not be distracted trying to do ellam cheyan nokkarathu, trying to be the jack of all trades. Paranjal onno rendo karyangal cheyda ninde business gunagaravayum. Glory to God. For you to finish your assignments, you need focus. Every distracting spirit, everything that takes focus away from that God has assigned you, tonight let it be broken. Amen. Oh, from your heart, from your mind, from your life, from your body, from your family, from our church. Yeah. In the name of Jesus, we give you praise. The fifth character that you need is endurance. Means staying power. Staying power. Jesus is our best example. Amidst all the pressure, he stayed in the God-given assignment. Judas betrayed him. Peter denied him. Disciples left him. Herod, hallelujah, publicly, hallelujah, publicly criticized him. But Jesus stood his ground. Hallelujah. Criticism did not move him. Pharisees, Sadducees did not move him. Hallelujah. Bible says the pressure was so much on the Garden of Gethsemane, he sweated blood. But still, in the midst of all the ridicule, all the betrayal, when people said, even if you are the Son of God, come down, he stayed in his, it's called staying power, endured the cross. Staying power. He stayed in his Father's assignment. He stayed on the cross for our redemption. That was his assignment, for our forgiveness of our sins, for our cleansing, for our salvation, to reconcile us to the Father. Oh, to purchase, hallelujah, redemption, and to make us peace with our God, Heavenly Father. He stayed in that. The cross was the assignment of Jesus. He faithfully stayed in that. He did not get upset when people did not stand with him. He stayed in it. Oh, glory to God. Sometimes people might fail you. Money might fail you. Things might... Oh, glory to God. But she stayed in that, because there is a God who never fails you. Glory to God. There is a God who is with you till the end of the age. Hallelujah. They even cried out, are you one of those prophets? Prove it. He did not try to prove people. Many people have left their God-given assignment. They're trying to prove a point. Pray today, Lord, let me not try to prove. Let me only do what God has called me to do. Let me only enter doors God has opened. Let me only do ministry God has asked me to do. There is no blessing to prove it. Faith is not for that. For faith to operate, you need endurance, staying power. Tonight, lift your hands and say, Lord, your grace to stay in course. Faith, the course. Staying power. Amen. Blessed be the name of Jesus. That's what Pastor taught us. Number six character, shame. How you handle shame. Somebody said in every assignment, there is a little bit of shame involved. Oh, hallelujah. A percentage of shame is attached to it. But what did Jesus do? He despised the shame. Oh, he endured the cross. You need to learn to despise it. Jesus was not ashamed of the cross. He despised the shame. Pastor said, when we were, you know, meeting as a church in a garden, people said, hey, you don't have a place to do worship. He said, I despised it. I despised the shame. And God gave him a garden-like property for people. Learn to despise the shame. Hallelujah. Once pastor was in the prayer room, Holy Spirit told him 10 lakhs people. Moment he came out of the prayer room, devil somehow smelled it. Somebody sent him a message saying, in front of 10 lakhs people, I'll make sure that you'll bow your knee. So immediately, somebody attacking what God has spoken. Pastor despised it. I despise that shame. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You have to despise. Some people say, what is shame? To be an associate pastor. Everybody wants to be senior pastor. Despise it. It's a God-given assignment. Nobody will grow. Despise it. Say, I'm going to grow. God will give me. Hallelujah. Mundiri odani chernu ninnal. If you stay the vine, if you have staying power, you will grow. God is the God of increase. Manishanalla ninne valathuna. God increases you when you are faithful. Hallelujah. You have to learn to practice this even in your marriage, your spouse. If you're ashamed of your spouse before family, friends, neighbors, there's something wrong. If you're shaming each other, you have to learn to endorse and honor your spouse before others. Hallelujah. Lord, help me to honor. Give me a spirit of honor, Lord. Hallelujah. Ralbhari, Kadagara, Sambhori, Balajara, Staradara, Balas. Family is a God-given assignment. Don't allow the devil to say, I'm in the Kudaman Nashichu. Amen. Pardon, did you hear it? Don't say it like that. Despise the shame. No, God gave me a good husband. God gave me a good wife. I honor her. Hallelujah. Praise God. God give me to bring favor into my life. Don't agree with other people and say, oh, this lady will, hallelujah, destroy my life. Don't have that kind of spirit. Pastor said when he was in North Carolina, Billy Graham's place, he was reading something about Billy Graham. Billy Graham touched, 11 American presidents with the gospel. One day when he was in North Carolina, one of the presidents called him to have a important discussion on the phone. And in between the phone, suddenly he told the president, President, give me a few minutes, just hold the line. And he went for 10 minutes and the president of America is holding the phone for 10 minutes. When he came back, he was curious. He asked, Billy, what happened? He said, my son broke the toy. He wanted me to fix it. So I was fixing it for him. American president had to wait for Billy Graham to fix the toy for his children. Because he said, that's my family. I have to honor my children. I have to honor my family. Jensen Franklin, he said, the day that American president invited him to White House to meet him, suddenly he remembered that was the day his son had told him months back that he had a ball game and he wanted his father to be there. He said, I did not think two minutes. He said, hallelujah. I immediately told president, I can come today. I have to go and meet the son and cheer him up for my ball game. Oh, hallelujah. You have to learn to honor. Can you imagine? Because he endorsed his family. The greatest job being a servant of God, not the president of the nation. Hallelujah. He endorsed and honored the family in front of even a president. Come on. Hallelujah. To serve God. And it is a God-given assignment to raise your family in the ways of God, to provide for your children. And Billy Graham was pretty clear about it. Who is more important? Oh, glory to God. Some of us have approval addiction. Everybody says something nice about me. Raising up as a young boy at the age of 17, and by 20 years I stepped out for God. I've It is so addictive when you go after what people say about me. My song, my talk. Did you hear that? Don't go after that. It's the one, only one audience you have, Jesus. Is he happy with me? Is my song, my praise, my worship have a divine approval? Approval addiction comes from the fear of man, self-centeredness. You won't enjoy Christianity and Christian ministry if you are approval conscious. Can you imagine Abraham looking at Sarah and saying, just tell me, is it a good idea to leave home and come out? You know, I heard from God. Did you hear? And Sarah is saying, I'm not sure. See, Abraham, God called him, he left. He was not looking for anybody's approval. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. You need faith, not people to approve around you. But God has called you, no matter who is for you or against you, go ahead and do it. That's what I've seen my dad doing, my pastor doing. That's what, you know, I believe my dad finished the assignment God has called him before God took him home. Because he did not look at the face of anybody. He just finished the race. You know, many people left him. Maybe by the time he went home, very, very few people. But there will be a cloud of witnesses who would have welcomed him back home. That's what matters. It's not even how you start, it's how you finish. I finished the course. Elliya gambira thalathode ella nee thodangi kaanum nee angane avasanippikunu. Blessed be the name of Jesus. If God has assigned to be the Petra Church in Bangalore, be a part of that. If not, back your blessing. Take a blessing. Back your backs and take a blessing. Hallelujah. And go. Call what God has called you to do. But if you are called to be in Petra Church, God has put you there. Be faithful there. Many of the battles that you are facing, I can see faces while I'm speaking to you. It's because you're not moving in the God-given assignment. Despise the shame. If somebody says, you go to that church, is he your pastor? We have heard so many things about it. Despise it. And say, he is my pastor. This is where I'm planted it. You need the character that is in Hebrews 12 to see your assignment fulfilled by faith. You have to have Jesus as your pattern. And the last thing, the assignment of Jesus was on the cross. But his reward was the throne. Hallelujah. There needs to be a certain level of character that you need to have to win and to be on the throne, the podium. The money will fail, the gift will fail, the charisma won't last, but love is a character that never fails. Throne is a place of authority, a certain level of authority. God has to know that you can handle power. Lucifer could not handle it. He was extremely close to the throne of God, but he couldn't handle that space. Some people, you know, you cannot put them there. They cannot handle that place. Devathe maati Lucifer irikkan nokki. Cannot handle that place. But look at Jesus. He humbled himself as a man. He stayed low in the presence of God. 1 Peter 5:7 TPT version. He stayed low and God exalted him and gave him a name that is above every other name. Bible says he humbled himself. Further, he became a bond servant. Furthermore, he died on the cross. He went down, 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 down. And God said, now I'm going to up, 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 up. Oh my Jesus. I felt a strong anointing in this house tonight in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus is our pattern. He's our example. He's our God. The character that is mentioned of these seven things is what God will give you the audacity of faith to run the race and to accomplish the God-given purpose. you believe it, lift your hands and say, Lord, I want it, Lord. I want it, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We give you praise. We give you glory. Thank you, Jesus. Let's sing a song of praise tonight. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Standing up or kneeling down, would you say this prayer with me? Lord Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
I surrender my life to you, the Lord.
I surrender my life to you, Lord.
I ask you tonight, Lord.
I ask you tonight.
Give me faith.
Give me faith.
Faith for my assignment, Lord.
Faith for my assignment, Lord.
I don't want to go after approval of people.
Approval of people.
I don't want to go after, Lord, what people think about me.
I want to go after, Lord, what people think about me.
I don't want to go after achievements.
I don't want to go after achievements.
I want to know my God-given assignment, Lord.
My God-given assignment, Lord.
I offer my heart for it.
I offer my heart for it.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Give me the grace.
Give me the grace.
To understand.
To understand.
What I'm called to do, Lord.
What I'm called to do, Lord.
If I'm called to be an Aaron, help me to be an Aaron, Lord.
Called to be an Aaron, Lord.
If I'm called to be associated and planted in a particular church, help me to do that faithfully, Lord Jesus.
Help me to do that faithfully, Lord Jesus.
Every weight.
Every weight.
Every sin.
Every sin.
That is ensnaring me.
Ensnaring.
I lay before you, Lord.
I lay before you, Lord.
Give me the patience.
Give me the patience.
Give me the endurance.
Give me the endurance.
To do the God-given assignments.
To do the God-given assignment.
I'm sorry for taking my face away from you, Lord.
I'm sorry for taking my face away from
today
you.
Today I choose to look to you, Lord Jesus.
Today I'm looking to you, Lord.
Despising Jesus. The shame.
Despising the shame.
And I know that you will lift me up.
And I know that you will lift me up.
To sit at your throne, Lord.
To sit at your throne, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
I surrender my life afresh tonight.
I surrender my life afresh tonight.
Submit to your assignment once again, Lord.
Submit to assignment once again, Lord.
I renounce Satan.
I renounce sin.
I renounce
sin.
I renounce the world.
I renounce the world.
May the small seed of faith.
May the small seed of
faith. Put it to work right now.
Be put it to work right
in
now.
The name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 Lift your hands and thank the Lord.
Oh,
thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Victory by the blood of Jesus. Victory by the blood of Jesus. We give you glory. We give you honor.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
Oh, hallelujah. All those who have accepted Jesus tonight as the Lord and Savior. Hallelujah. Let's take a piece of bread tonight, wherever you are, and celebrate the Lord's table tonight. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
For every seed of the Lord which I also delivered unto you. The Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and said, take heed, this is my body which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Father, we thank you for the body of Jesus. We thank you having broken for us, that we shall be put whole. I thank you, Lord, you said your food is to do your work, Lord, and to finish it, Lord. Your assignment was to do God's will. And to finish it, Lord, give us the grace as we partake of the bread to finish it well. The assignment God has given us to do, Lord Jesus. Remove every distraction, remove every hindrance, remove every addictions, remove every sin, and help us to look to Jesus, the author and the finer of our faith. Bless this bread, bless our life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Let's partake of the bread together today.
Stone, you live to die, rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall and thought of me above all. Rejected and alone, like a rose traveled on the ground. You took the fall and thought of me above all.
After the same manner, I also took the cup and he ends up saying, this cup is the New Testament in my blood. This do ye as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. We thank you, Lord, for your blood. We thank you, Lord, for your cleansing blood. The blood of our remission, the blood of our forgiveness. The blood that speaks a better word over our lives. We thank you, we've not come to Mount Sinai, but Mount Jerusalem. We thank you, Jesus, that the blood of Jesus speaks better word than the blood of Abel. We thank you, Jesus, by the power of your holy blood that can cleanse us from every offense, from every sin, that everything that is tripping us down again and again, that can break the power of crawling, that can break the power of curse. Thank you, Jesus. Tonight, for the holy blood that has given us victory and blessing, we receive it by faith in Jesus' name. Bless this cup, bless our life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Let's partake of this cup together tonight. For as often as we do this, hallelujah, as often as we eat this bread, drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until He comes. Let's lift our hands and thank the Lord that one of these days He will come back and take us back home. If you are happy, joyful, lift your hands. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Father, I commit the church into your hands. I pray that the joy of doing and fulfilling your assignment to come upon the people again, Lord. Hallelujah. To run the race with joy and to endure the cross. Father, let them run with joy again. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Let there be consistency that be attached to our lives. Father, in the name of Jesus, as I commit the people into your hands, I bless them. I bless them in the name of the Father. I bless them in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. I bless them in the name of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Look at two people and say, you look too blessed. Hallelujah. You look too blessed. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. I'll see you on Sunday. Till that time, Jesus Christ is Lord. Let's have a final song. Hallelujah.
വിശ്വാസത്താലെന്നും മുന്നേറും ഞാൻ, വിശ്വാസത്താലെല്ലാം ചെയ്തിടും ഞാൻ, വിശ്വാസത്താലെന്നും മുന്നേറും ഞാൻ, വിശ്വാസത്താലെല്ലാം ചെയ്തിടും ഞാൻ. ഒന്നും അസാധ്യമായില്ല എൻ്റെ മുൻപിൽ ഇനി ജയം എനിക്കുണ്ട്. ഞാനൊട്ടും പിന്മാറുകില്ല, വിശ്വാസ ചുവൻ മുന്നോട്ട് മുന്നോട്ട്. ആരെല്ലാം എതിർത്താലും എന്തെല്ലാം ഭാവിച്ചാലും പിന്മാറുകളിനി ഞാൻ, അധികാരത്തോടെ ഇനി കൽപ്പിക്കും ഞാൻ, പ്രതികൂലങ്ങൾ മാറിപ്പോകും. വാദം അസാധ്യമായില്ല എൻ്റെ മുൻപിൽ ഇനി ജയം എനിക്കുണ്ട്. ഒന്നും അസാധ്യമായില്ല എൻ്റെ മുൻപിൽ ഇനി ജയം എനിക്കുണ്ട്. സാധ്യമായില്ല എൻ്റെ മുൻപിൽ.